dear friends, it's me Odo, and we are back in our campaign of EU4 with Ethiopia. last time we had a war to break up the coalition, and we got rid of Delhi inside this coalition, which is a big play, which was a big player in the coalition. But there are still some left. What's the coalition stuff? State edicts. Diplomatic. So we still have Malwa, Sirhind, Transoxiana, and last but not least, the Ottomans in the coalition. So we really want to get rid of one of them. But Transoxiana is only allied to Oirat and Malwa, and Oirat is somewhere here, so it's not an option to get rid of them. Malwa is just allied with Sirhind. And Sirhind is only allied with Malwa, so we can't get rid of them. And I'm really not sure if I can get rid of the Ottomans, but they have some more alliances, like with Hormuz. I really want to get rid of Hormuz anyway. And with Mali? Really? Where is Mali? Ah, it's on the other side of the board. There is Mali. Yeah. It's not interesting for us as well. But probably we can do, and we can work with Hormuz, because we have a casus belli against Hormuz. Do we have a casus belli against Hormuz? And probably we can get rid of the Ottomans by making a peace with Hormuz. Then the Ottomans will have a truce as well, and they will be out of the coalition. Probably. Probably. But we'll have to have a casus belli against them. Do we have a casus belli against them? They have a reconquest on us, but do we have a conquest on them? No, I don't think so. We need to have a casus belli on them before the it's by network. Yeah, it's okay. Oh, I see. Necht is going down because they are not allied with us anymore. Yeah. That's too bad for you. Yeah, I was trying to... Can we declare... Ah, we can take Sufra. What's Sufra? So it's okay. If we'd... Can we declare war? No. Ah, we have a trade power stuff with them. Okay, yeah, let's build a spy network on them anyway. So, yeah, we tried to consolidate our power, and what we did was we... Why don't you trade? I mean, didn't I tell you you should do that? Also, why are you transferring to Hormuz and not to the Gulf of Aden? I mean, this is terrible. I need more merchants. I really don't know how to get more merchants. The problem is, if we take the merchant from the Gulf of Aden to here, then from the Gulf of Aden we won't do the transfer to Zanzibar, and in Zanzibar, and if we would take the guy from Zanzibar, we wouldn't collect trade here, so we wouldn't make money. I really don't know how to change. I really don't know if I have the DLC to change my what's it called, my trading capital. We want probably also to promote some cultures like Swahili. We already have three. We can't do any more. So we should probably start to integrating cultures as well. But Swahili we will probably take as a primary culture in the future when we get tech to do so. But first we want our fourth idea group. Yay! Idea group. I really don't know what I do at the moment. I really, really don't know what I'll do. So, if we protect trade here, why does it transfer my trade power to the Gulf of Aden? Who really needs the trade in the Hormuz trade node? I really don't need there. I mean, you can enhance your merchants, I know, with trading companies, but I really don't know if my DLC even allows trading companies. So we lost a lot of people here in our war with Gujarat and Delhi. And also because we ran into a rebellion with my troops in this spread it out, which was terrible. And there are these 21,000 troops in Kalat. I hoped I could get rid of this probable rebellion, but it triggered before I came back with all my troops. Yeah, I took some more troops just to get rid of some of the rebellious subjects. So there it's going down. There it still goes up. It goes down here. Kalonga. Where is Kalonga? Kalonga. Looks like, yeah, somewhere here. So let's take my mercenaries. They should be enough to suppress in Kalonga. And we suppress here. Stop it, stop it, stop it. Our truce with Busoga has ended. Yeah, that's not interesting. We've lost the trade. Yeah, because we got trade power from them again, I believe. Oh, Syria, that was here. Yeah. because we did some war with them to get it again. Which is quite profitable. Let's see. Do we have some profitable metal workshops? Probably. Nah. We could get some money to upgrade a few of our force. This would be good probably. As we should have level 2 force now. So, yeah, there's still this 4 on, so, yeah. What? Almost got this? Why? Was this rebelling? Didn't I see that? And they also lost Maskalat. Ah, Faz, you're so stupid. I am so stupid. Yeah, then we have some more reasons to fight you, almost, probably. We also want to fight them. But we still have a truce with them. So when does the truce with Hormuz end? In 1603. Yeah, we've got some time there, and with Hedjas it ends. Do we have a truce with Hedjas? Nah. But they still transfer trade power to us. Interesting. Do we have some? We have some truce with them as well. For our new vassal Davasir. So, yeah, that's okay. Is this enough to stop them? Probably yes. 0.6. How many troops, how many infantry do we need for 0.6? We have now 4 infantry. Let's show me how many infantry I need. Yeah, it's 1.0. Why is it 1.0? Really don't know. Omani separatists. Ugh. So many separatists. Yeah, you still get more troops before we attack that. We are still at minus 14%, so yeah, we've got some time there. And you probably can take care of the Omani separatists as well. 1.5. 6 troops at 1.5. So 1 troop is a 1.5 through 6. That's 0.25. So 1 infantry is 0.25 suppression. So how many suppression do we need there? Yeah, 1.6, 1.6, and 1.6. So it's 777 infantry. So first of all, take a 7th infantry. we've done with this. So how about these guys? I mean, we have no unrest here anymore. So how about that? Yeah, we're at 40%, so we just let it get down for more months. And then we'll ship them to take care of the Omani rebels. There is one DLC where you can suppress but I don't have this I don't have this DLC. We can take tech. Yay, scientific experimentation. We didn't think of what idea group we'll take next. So we have innovative, offensive and influence, which are probably good, I hope. Influence is good because of the vassals. Innovative is good because everything's cheaper. And offensive was good because I really don't know. So we've got at the time we need a diplomatic policy. Diplomatic policy? Is it called like that? So probably we should take something here like diplomacy, diplomatic ideas or trade ideas to get some traders. Or even exploration to get some colonists, because we have a lot of uncolonized land around us. That would probably make sense. I really don't know if it would make sense. Or religious ideas, because we really want to get rid of all these stupid idiots. So, which kind of ideas do I get if I'll which kind of yeah, what's it called, what's this called, policies, which kind of policies do we get if we take religious ideas? We have offensive, so we get the Anti-Heresy Act, which increases my missionary strength enormously and my religious unity. This is great. This is really great. And we've got influence. We get better culture conversion cost. Okay, that's not that interesting. And what do we have as well? Ah, yeah, and we have innovative, but we won't get anything with innovative because that's also an admin stuff. So, yeah, the Military Seal Act is really good. The Anti-Heresy Act is really good, I believe. Although heretics, other Christians? Probably, it's only other Christians. But anyway, plus 20% religious unity is really good. How about humanist ideas? They are probably also nice. We get diplomatic reputation with the Foreign Aid Act, and the Liberation Act gets national unrest -1 And years of separatism minus 5, that's also good. That's also nice. And one of these is really a good pick probably for us. Yeah, what do we have here? Exploration. Why should we take exploration? Trade power abroad plus 50%. Ship durability plus 5%. Do we get the trader as well as merchant as well? Nah. How about trade ideas? What can we do with trade ideas? I didn't look at trade ideas before, so as we have some problems with the trade, I'm probably interested in that because it's two traders that we get. Global trade power plus 20%. Yeah, that's okay, I believe. Trade range, I don't think that this is a problem for us. National trade policy, trade efficiency plus 10%. Oh yeah, that's good. To traders, to merchants, trade steering plus 25%, and caravan power plus 25%. Probably not the best things that we can get. But we get another trade efficiency with the innovative, so that's okay. Plus 20% trade efficiency is okay, I believe. And we've got Public Road Act, which also gives us trade efficiency plus 10%. And movement speed plus 10%. Yeah, that's okay probably, but yeah. It will increase our revenue anyway. So what about diplomatic ideas? So we get diplomats. I'm really bad with diplomats, but we get also diplomatic relations. Plus one. Ah, we can get one more vassal or ally or stuff. Yeah, that's okay. Improve relations, yeah. Experience diplomats plus 2. Reputation. Minus 20% province war score cost, that's okay. And minus 10% diplomatic technology cost, yeah, that's a bit late, but okay, I believe. What do we have here with policies? Offend the underhanded diplomacy act. Diplomatic reputation up. Mercenaries up. Yeah, well, that's wished in German. Advisor cost minus 10%. And diplomatic reputation up. Yeah, that's okay. That's probably nice. So, how about military? We could take aristocratic. Get the production efficiency up and national unrest down and the vessel force limit contribution up. No, that's nice if we work with vessels. Also, we get a discount on military on military technology costs, and we get another diplomat. Mercenaries are wished, as we said before. Autonomy change minus, this is also nice. Cavalry cost down is not so interesting, I believe. I really don't know. Exploration would be probably also good. Great. There is also expansion, where we also get a merchant, a colonist and a merchant. Faster settler. Trade power. Another diplomat. Another diplomatic reputation, another colonist. So it's two colonists with expansion. And trade power. Income from vessels go up. And with offensive we get automatically discover adjacent when a colony is built. Yeah, that's not so interesting. Nah, religious is better. It's much better. We got missionaries. We got... Nah, that's not so interesting. We got missionary strength. Yeah, we'll probably take religious ideas. Why not? I believe that's good for us. Now I did it, so we can't change it anymore. So with this decision, should we stop one of these two? I really want to lead a siege plus one. But do we need a diplomatic relation plus one and reinforce? Yeah, reinforce cost minus 20% is also nice. Why is it here and not with the... Oh, with the religious we get this cultural unity stuff. Yeah, anyway. Let's wait before until these are at 0% in hedges, and then we'll transport them back to... What? Ah, yeah, we converted someone. So, what do we do next? This is really so expensive. Lunda. But they are... Oh, there is so much... religious unity to be gained by that. We are only at 60% now. We really need to do this. It's so expensive, but really, really, we should do this. It's like 26, really, per month in Aden. Ah, I can't believe this. But this is a state, so we could turn on the edicts. State edicts. We have here a state edict on, and here. Where do we... There's one province where we still... Well, there are, but that's down there. Isn't it? Yeah. So these two state edicts will be... So this will save us money. So if we turn on the state edict here, we can do these three. tights and Arden. I have tights and Arden. Arden is really, really expensive, but now it's only 16 instead of 19 months. Baihan and tights are also rather expensive. This is probably will start with tights. Baihan. Let's start with Baihan. It's the least expensive and it's the fastest in getting done. So nearly down to zero, and we should probably take care of these rebels now. We're nearly full, so yeah, let's do this. And then we could take care of this Gujarati separatists down there. Integration of the Oromo. Oh, thank you. It seems the voice of the Oromo settlers moving into our lands have finally faltered. The immigrants themselves have also begun to settle down, and while our society is changed in many ways, the violent initial phase of integration of these new people seem to be over. Yeah, that's nice. So we can start to move there. Copts again. So let's get rid of these rebels. Again, I believe Multan will be great to do war with, because do we have claims on Multan? Nah, not really, but we can fabricate claims there probably sometime in the future. Yeah, we do try to do a spy network there. So now, first of all, you guys get onto the ship and will be transferred to Muscat. So do we have still some separatism here? No, Omani separatism. Ashakri, Mazir and Muscat. So go to Mazira. -1.75, yeah, that's great. Whatever. So we got rid of them. Great. Now come here again. Got rid of this separatism, that's great. And let's that's really great. We stabilized our country. Yeah, and the next time we will try to expand it again. Until then, dear friends, have a nice evening, sleep well. Bye.